Welcome to Todd Talk. Today I want to talk to you a little bit about what's in store for 2024.
Todd Talk is brought to you by art. It's cool.
So I have always been a creative type. And when I was little, I used to draw quite a lot. And then as I got a little bit older, I started to get into music. And then I got into writing and filmmaking, everything else. Really, the thing that kind of ties it all together is kind of storytelling. I like to tell stories. And so drawing, that's one way to do that. Writing a song, that's another way to do that. I started writing because you could do it by yourself. You didn't have to have like a crew or a bunch of people. You could pretty much put onto paper anything that you could imagine. I've done some short films, and short films are fun because you get to collaborate with people. You get to bring in different ideas and different things, and it's cool to make something with some people. When I look back on all the art I've created, one thing that I realize is my art is not very marketable. And what I mean is, while I am inspired by people like Stephen King and Trent Reznor and Christopher Nolan, I tend to make stuff that's more like H.P. Lovecraft or Velvet Underground or David Lynch. I don't make things that are popular or mainstream. I make things that are ugly and things that make people feel something. And you know, some artists, they can figure it out. You know, they make things that people really resonate with, or a lot of people resonate with, and they can make a living doing that. And then there's other artists who just make art to get a reaction or get it out there. And I fall much more into that camp. Now, the reason a lot of you are watching this is because of my Minecraft videos. When the whole pandemic thing happened and we were locked down, I had some free time on my hands and I decided I'm going to start making Minecraft videos. And the reason was, A, I like to play Minecraft, B, I like to edit video, and C, I like to make music. And this was a really awesome creative outlet for all of those things. When you watch one of my Minecraft videos, I create it and I put it all together and edit it and I do all the music for it. And it's a really cool way to do a lot of the different creative types of things I like to do. And it's been great. I'm going on 3-ish years of this Minecraft series, and I've had slow, steady growth. This year I got monetized on YouTube, and while I'm not making a ton of money, I am making some money, which is kind of interesting. There's one video I made about 2 years ago called All About Water. And it is just a video about Minecraft water and all the weird mechanics with that. And every week since I've made it, it has been my most viewed video. I get thousands and thousands of views. Any money I make, which again is minuscule, it's from that video. And that's something interesting that I realized is if I stopped making videos today, that video would continue to generate views and make money. And that's how YouTubers do it. It's not necessarily each video gets a million views. It's that you have this catalog of videos that people continue to visit, and that all adds up. And when I look at my analytics, the videos at the top are always my tutorials and my how-to videos. You know, the feedback I get about how I explain things is really great, and people just think I do a good job of simplifying really complex ideas. And you know, if I wanted to game it, I could just make tutorials and I could just make how-to videos. But the thing I like to do is just this weekly series of me building in this world and talking to the audience. And that's kind of something I promised myself, is this is going to be about what I want to do and not about chasing a number or figuring out how to satisfy the algorithm. I just want to do what I like to do, because I'm sure there are some people out there who will also like it. Again, it might not be millions of people. I'm not doing the thing that everybody wants, but I'm doing the thing that I like, and I know there are people out there who like the same thing. And so this year in 2024, I'm just gonna keep doing what I've been doing. I'm gonna keep working on the Let's Play episodes. As new things kind of come out, I will work on some of the how-tos and my opinions of the different updates. And once we get to the next big update, 1.21, I think I'm gonna start a second series. I don't know that I'm gonna make more videos, but I'm going to do two different types of videos at least. because I want to diversify a little bit. You know, whenever you start something new, it drums up some new interest, and I think I would like to do that. I'm not going to abandon the world that I'm working on now, but I would like to start something different. So another thing I've been thinking about is when I look at my website, if you haven't visited, you should visit. I'll put the link on the screen right here. But when I visit my website or my Instagram, the thing I put in my description is art, film, music, Minecraft. And you know, I feel like that kind of sums up what I'm about. Art, music, film, Minecraft. Those are the things that kind of occupy my brain, regardless of what I'm doing. That's kind of what's churning up here and what I'm thinking about. And I feel like I've done a really good job with the Minecraft. But the other ones, I feel like I've neglected a little bit. And so in 2024, I want to do more of that. So a few of you may know, I do actually have a second YouTube channel. I think the channel has like 10 followers, so most people don't know about it. But all of the short films and things that I've done, I've parked over there just because I didn't want to confuse or muddy up the Todd 13 Plays YouTube channel. But I think I'm going to talk about it more. Some of the movies I've made are really fun or really interesting or things I'm pretty proud of. And as far as Todd 13 Plays, the reason I selected that was because I imagined I might play other games or I might play music. And again, I want to do more of that. So 2024, here's what I'm thinking. Minecraft, I'm going to keep powering on through that, diversify the series a little bit so it makes it a little bit more interesting, and I think it's going to be great. As far as the music, I'm going to make more Minecraft music. I would like to do more experimental music, you know, things that I just haven't messed around with before. And I'd also like to do more like rock music. I used to play in bands and things all the time back in the day. I sort of just burned out on it. I got tired of the late nights and dealing with the band members and dealing with the club. And it was just a lot. And I'd be just very interested to revisit that sort of music and see all these years later, what does that voice sound like? You know, there's other things. I wrote a musical, like, 30 years ago, and I have a demo of it, and I novelized it. So if you look at my writing, it's a short story that I wrote, but you know, I've never done anything with it. I've always thought it'd be fun to perform it, but just never have. And as far as art, you know, I've been investigating some interesting things. I've been kind of toying around with the idea of projection mapping. I really like the idea of like street art and that sort of thing, live performance. People have told me I should do a one-man show. So I've just got all these ideas and I want to do something with them. So Minecraft, music, art, film. Film, I've done some short films on my own before and they're very fun and interesting. But the ones I'm most proud of, I've done with other people. And usually those have been part of either a film festival or a film race. So this year I would like to do a couple of those. I'm thinking either like the 48-hour film festival or 24-hour film race. I've done the 72-hour horror film race before. So I would like to do a couple of those projects. And yeah, all of these things, all this art, all this music, all these films, I want to share these with you and involve you. Again, I know most of you have found me through Minecraft, but obviously, as you can see, I'm a real human being and I do other things, and I would like to involve you in some of those things too, if you're interested. And one thing I've always kind of been very adamant about and I've kind of promised myself is I'm not going to hide any of this behind a paywall. My Minecraft videos, my short films, my music, all of that, I want to be available to whoever wants it. But I know there are people out there who would like to be more involved or who would like to support the work that I do. And so in 2024, I'm going to offer a couple of membership type things. Now, as far as YouTube goes, again, nothing will change. You can watch all of the videos, you can comment, you can join the Discord, all of that will be available. But if you want to get more out of the channel, I'm going to offer YouTube memberships starting at 99 cents. So if you want to get more involved, if you want to do more fun things, I will have that on the YouTube. Just click on the little join thing for more details, and it'll tell you all about it. Now, if you want to support me directly or get more involved, I'm going to offer memberships on Buy Me a Coffee. Buy Me a Coffee gives most of the money to creators, where YouTube takes a fairly sizable chunk. Buy Me a Coffee is a great way to support all of the creators that you're into. And I want to do more things where I am more collaborative so that we connect every month. I share progress reports on things I'm working on, things like that. Again, if that sounds interesting, I'll leave a link in the description. If not, totally fine. Everything on the channel is still all free and available. So really, that's the plan for 2024. A little bit more Minecraft, a little bit more art, a little bit more music, a little bit more film. More ways for you to get involved, more content, more stuff to look at. I think it's going to be really, really awesome. You know, those of you who tune in each week and who leave me comments and who join me on the live streams, I really, really appreciate you all. There was a thing that happened last year where Pixel Riffs mentioned me in one of his videos. Now, Pixel Riffs, one of the biggest Minecraft YouTubers there is. And I got a ton of subscribers and a ton of views from that mention. But the coolest thing was when I picked up my phone in the morning, I had hundreds of comments. And all day my phone was just going ding, ding, ding. And there were so many people who had stuff to say about something I did and questions for me based on the thing I did that I was able to help and to answer. And it was just really cool to have that community. Now, obviously, that was Pixel Riffs' community, and I got to be in that spotlight for a moment, but I would love to build something up like that. A community of people who are really into creativity and art, music, and Minecraft and film. And I think that's all I got to say about that. Again, thank you all for tuning in and checking out my videos. I really, really appreciate you. I hope you have a great 2024, and I'll see you in the next one.